Welcome back, everybody. Today we will speak about a small company which crashed 30% in last few weeks. I will tell you what is their business, how does their balance sheet looks like, how are they different from their competitors. Of course, we will also speak about cause of their stock price crash, and actually I will explain to you why did I invest $3,000 in this particular stock. But as always, before we move on, I would like to give you a short recap performance of my portfolio. As you can see, the biggest change compared to last video is ratio between equity and cash. My cash position has dropped significantly because I was buying few different stocks last week. I will disclose to you only one stock in this video, but in the future I will explain to you exactly what I did, when did I do it, and why did I do it. So my portfolio is at this moment sitting around $42,000, and compared to S&P 500, I am around 19% outperforming it year to date. Without further ado, the stock about which we are going to speak today is Revolve. Revolve Group operates as an online fashion retailer for consumers in the United States and internationally. That is their core business. They are actually online fashion retailer. As you can see here, I have bought 150 shares at average price of $17.85. If you have perhaps been watching my old videos, you maybe remember that I used to own this stock. I bought 400 shares at around $8 after it crashed in March. And then stock kept going up, even when they reported earnings, which really disappointed me actually, because coronavirus impacted them more than I really expected. But stocks kept going up even after that. So I sold all of my stocks at around $16, you can see it here. But I kept tracking this stock and all the news about it, because I generally liked their product, their story and their management. So I wanted to see how are they going to cope these disruptions in the markets, and if new opportunity for me will present itself again. But the stock kept going up, and when it was around $19, they reported earnings for second quarter and stock skyrocketed. It went from around $19 to all around $24. What happened actually is that they crushed expectations whenever you looked in their revenue, in their cash flow, net income, balance sheet, debt. They really crashed every single segment of their report. You can see here, monthly net sales for June 2020 increased year on year for the first time since the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. So they resumed their year on year revenue growth in June. Then again, you can see here that international net sales increased 3% year on year. So while US sales have decreased, international sales have increased. So they are additionally diversifying. You can see it even better on this chart. My personal opinion is that diversifying is always good. On profitability segment, you can see that as previously disclosed, in early April 2020, the company took a variety of actions to align its cost structure with the significantly reduced consumer demand it was experiencing at the time, primarily through furlough and temporary reductions to salaries, wages and hours. So given the highly uncertain demand environment. And then the company's improving monthly trend in net sales during the second quarter meaningfully outperformed the underlying assumptions embedded in its reduced cost structure. So in the other words, they actually overdid it with preparing to coronavirus impact, which is actually a good move to do because there was a lot of uncertainty and nobody knows how deep this impact is going to be. So they prepared for the worst, and luckily for them and for us, the worst case scenario didn't appear and they managed to start growing again. And consequently, you can see here that the company has rolled back many of its COVID-19 related cost containment actions. Effective August 1st, 2020, the company returned the majority of its furlough employees to full schedule and salary. And what I liked most in their second quarter is this: cash and equivalents as of June 30, 2020 were $151 million, an increase of $47.2 million. And then they also repaid $6 million of its revolving credit line. So they managed to increase their cash position for one third, and they decreased their credit line in the same time, simply by using their free cash flow. That is just a magnificent thing to do. Remember, this is a small company. Market cap of this company is $1.2 billion, and they generated $50 million of free cash flow in second quarter. That is more than they have generated in all of 2019. So their capabilities of generating cash flow in these rough times really amazed me. I have also, of course, listened to earnings call, and then I have pulled some of the most interesting things that management said. Of course, they have confirmed that now they have $151 million in cash on the balance sheet, and they are going to reinvest in inventory to support future demand and further invest in the business to drive long-term growth. Again, I expected that in the third quarter, significant drop in free cash flow. But again, when I see how are they investing it, I don't have anything against it in the short run, because I think that we will be really well rewarded in the future by these investments. Then again, they mentioned that the positive year-over-year net sales growth in June carried through to July and early August, with the quarter-to-date period showing low single-digit growth on a year-on-year basis. You can see it even better on this chart. You can see how trend positive year-on-year growth in net sales is driving that revenue higher. And then again, they confirmed that this continued to the third quarter too. Another interesting thing is that Revolve Beauty products have been phenomenal, with net sales increasing approximately 150% year-over-year in July. This is the fourth straight month that the beauty category net sales have increased more than 100 year-over-year. That are really, really impressive numbers. Of course, base for the beauty segment is really low, so it is not such a rare thing to see triple-digit growth. But again, when I see a company which is undervalued and that it has a segments which are growing this fast, it really gets me excited. Then there are some interesting things that they are doing in the marketing segment. You can see that main way of marketing for Revolve company is that Instagram Live and Instagram TV. They think that they are both highly engaging and extremely cost effective. That is actually where I think that they are different from their competitors. Of course, they are producing their own products. They are not just reselling it on their e-commerce store. But again, not only that they are different from other commerce retailers by producing their own stuff, but they are also using these specific marketing channels, and they are doing it extremely, extremely well. And of course, that's why they are having such a high margins for this industry. Again, when we are speaking about cash flow, you can see on this chart very well that they are actually decreased their inventory and their capital expenditures. Of course, that reflected on cash flow. You can see it compared to second quarter 19. Again, I don't think that we will see this high free cash flow as they had in second quarter anytime soon. But it is really a nice thing to see that they are capable of doing this when it's most needed. So now we are coming to interesting part. Why did this stock fell for more than 30% from their highs, which they have reached recently? So they went from $24 to below 18 bucks. So what pushed them actually from 20, 21 bucks to below 18 is this news. Shares of the online fashion retailer, Revolve, are down more than 12% after the Fly.com reported the sale of a 4 million share block. So basically, Revolve stocks has fallen because some other company started selling shares of Revolve. And basically, nothing bad happened at the company. Nothing bad happened around their products, about their inventory, about their sales. There is nothing negative going on right now. But investors were spooked by the Fly.com because they started selling shares of Revolve. This type of sell-off is something that I love, and it gave me opportunity to come back to this magnificent company, and I simply took this opportunity and I bought 150 shares. If perhaps shares continue going down, I might double this position. But at this moment, I'm happy that I managed to buy even 150 shares after those great, great results that they achieved in second quarter. Another interesting comment about insiders buying and selling is that when somebody is buying stock, they are buying it for only one reason, because they think stock is undervalued and it will go higher. But when somebody is selling stock, for example, the Fly.com, it can be selling stocks for 1,000 reasons. Perhaps this company has problems and they need cash. Perhaps they have some other investing opportunity and that's why they need cash. You shouldn't worry about somebody else selling your stock. If stock sells off because somebody else is selling it, you should take advantage of that situation. Thank you very much for watching this video. Hopefully you have gained some valuable information. Please do your own due diligence. Don't just follow me before making decision about buying this stock.